Blessed be God, the God of the ends of the earth, the only one who is the owner and possessor of the heavens and the earth, the one with whom there is no impossibility, the one that knows the end from the beginning, Alpha and Omega, the mighty God, the ancient of days, the God of glory, God of great grace, we exalt you. Oh, hallelujah. You are welcome to this session. And I believe the Lord, it shall be a glorious time. I want us to go straight by praying. Bow your head in prayer. And I want you to begin to receive grace and favor. Father in heaven, we come by faith this evening with the consciousness of the ability of God to bless. I ask, O Lord, that your word will come explicitly. Your word will come with precision. Your word will come with power. And there shall be a release of your anointing upon this word today. Holy Spirit, have your right of way. Glorify Jesus. Let all the hearers be blessed. Let this bring salvation, bring deliverance, bring restoration, and let it bring signs and wonders to every life. By this message today, let destinies change for good. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. And the people of God say, Amen. I'm sure you've had a wonderful day. I'm glad to continue in our series, Hearing from God. Tonight, I want to attempt to concentrate on developing a sensitive spirit and sensitivity to the Holy Spirit, which is very important. We have seen a lot from what we have read, and I believe you will recapitulate, you will run over and over again. You need to be sensitive in your spirit, and you need to be sensitive to the Holy Spirit, so you can pick signal, so you can be current with God, so you will not be a lone ranger, so you will not just use head knowledge, but you can be under divine influence, which culminates in dominion in every area of your life. Praise the Lord. The case of Prophet Elijah came to mind, looking at this subject this evening. Can you imagine if Elijah never had that encounter? The Bible says in 1 Kings chapter 18, he had just had a very great victory. He had just wiped out the entire Baal, the prophets of Baal. One would expect that should be a time of jubilating and rejoicing. The same man was confronted by a woman. Only a woman, not women. And he became jittery. That must have been high-level witchcraft. The man ran into the bush and was asking God to kill him. Were it not for the encounter that he had God, his ministry would have been terminated before his time. And I want to say to you, your sensitivity to the Spirit of God and your being sensitive in the Spirit and your spirit man being sensitive, it's going to help you to get to your goal, for you not to be stagnated or to die before your time. So Elijah eventually was assigned by God to do many more things. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will not be cut off in the middle of your age. You will fulfill destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. This is the importance of hearing from God. Hearing from God is very, very vital. Praise the Lord. And so God had to tell Elijah the journey is still very long. It's still very long. And without this encounter, he would not have passed the baton to Elisha. And I wonder what would have happened. So, be very sensitive. Learn to listen, learn to yield. This Elijah as a prophet is a very good case study for each one of us to see the importance of hearing from God. It's important that you note it when you learn the art of hearing from God, it becomes possible to avert dangers. It becomes possible to avert calamities and woes. And then God's dealing with you in hearing Him will affect every area of your life. Hallelujah. It will direct you. It will lead you to who to marry. It will lead you to what business to enter. It will lead you to what city to stay. It will lead you to where to fellowship. It will lead you to what ventures to go to in business. So you will not run into dry ground. Praise the Lord. And it's my prayer you will not be extinct in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You will also not be extinct before you finish your work. So when we learn the art of learning, the art of listening, it goes a long way to enlarge our coasts. Praise the Lord. And then that will help us as to how to navigate in life. So as we are looking at this topic from where we started, please go back, ruminate over them, think about them, and then you will be the best in life. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. For you to also receive God's call for your life, you need to know how to hear from Him. Hallelujah. If you want to advance the kingdom, you want to fulfill destiny, you want to finish your work, hearing from God is a must. Praise the Lord. So if you are interested in any of this, you have no choice, you have to hear from Him. How can you actually fulfill God's mandate when you are not in tune with Him, when you are not engaged with Him? Hallelujah. I look back, I'm eternally grateful. This is an area where I give glory to God. Every phase of my life, there was an encounter. I had God. And it meant so much. It meant so much. I remember as an undergraduate, just before I entered into my master's degree course, I had God telling me what I will become in the future. I'm talking of 36, 38 or so years ago. Amazingly. And I knew then, yeah, God is not calling me to a full-time work yet. So glaring, so clear. So hearing from God will not let you dot about, because we were spiritually inclined in executive, we were being used of God. We just wanted to serve God. But it's God who determines how you are going to serve Him. Hallelujah. And every phase, every step had been dictated by His Spirit. Hallelujah. So it's important you have to learn to develop sensitive spirit. It is that same sensitive spirit you will link up with the Holy Spirit, where you can become sensitive to the Holy Spirit. But your spirit must first be sensitive. Praise God. The first thing is you need to be acquainted with the Holy Spirit Himself. Hallelujah. You have to open up to the spirit of revelation, which is the Spirit of God. Your spirit man must be inclined. If you are going to hear from God, you become acquainted. It's important that believers must not see the Holy Spirit like the wind, like the fire. We must see Him as the third person of Trinity. The Holy Spirit is a personality, co-equal, co-eternal with God. Many times believers, Jesus, we know Jesus. Jesus is our Savior, etc. Some say, God, Yahweh, the Almighty, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. But when it comes to the Holy Spirit, we are using it, etc. And we're just lost out there. You have to cultivate a deep knowledge and a walk with the Spirit of God. Praise the Lord. So that you can be the best from God. Beyond receiving direction, it also brings you even the gifts of the Spirit. Hallelujah. So, as you hear from God, and these gifts flow in your life, you will get to a point where there will be a release in your human spirit. Don't forget, we said man is a tripartite being. He's a spirit, he has a soul, and he lives in a body. Each of these three compartments must be developed. That's why in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, it says, the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. And I pray God your spirit, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, it's important that you get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. The Bible is talking about sanctification of the whole you. Your spirit, your soul, your body. And that's why anybody who wants to go far with God, anybody who is going to actually have fun with God, in quote, have a flow. You are not just going to be there mechanically, not just routine work. No. You are going to explore all the possibilities. You are going to begin to know the Holy Spirit as a person. The Bible says, God sanctify you, which means set apart. God wants every area of our lives to be set apart. Set apart for a holy use. So you get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. You spend some time praying in the Spirit. You spend some time listening to the voice of the Spirit. You calm yourself. I remember when we were learning to hear from God. Oh, there were those times you finish all the prayers, you are waiting, but you are hearing nothing. The tendency is to be discouraged. But with time, we began to hear in a sequential way. Step by step, stage by stage. And as we were hearing, now let me just say this to you. You don't wake up today and tell me, oh, God has said this. Do you have an antecedent? Have you been able to prove what he has said before? Because that's the way to show. Oh, yes, I remember I had him and it came to pass. He said this and it was fulfilled. I remember a few occasions. I've given this testimony before. We were waiting for the fruit of the womb after marriage. And then it got to a point where I need to slot it out. And I went into another room, separate from where my wife and myself used to sleep. I went to another room in the middle of the night. I started. I wanted to do operation push. Pray until something happens. First day for hours and hours and hours. Second day, hours and hours and hours. Third day, I heard God say it is done. Now you see, these are some of the ways by which you get to prove your line of hearing God. Dearly beloved, pregnancy had eluded us for more than 10 full months consecutively. We were always desirous. But that very month, the pregnancy of our first child stayed. Now you see, by that I was encouraged, which means I didn't hear from myself. I heard from God. And that's how, now I'm talking of 1985. And that's how, step by step, other occasions like that, on and on like that, I remember when we were waiting for God again for the second child. I remember how I prayed the other time, 3 days consecutively, real prayers. At least each day, it was not less than 8 hours. So when it was time for a second child, I said, yes, I want to go into it again, operation push. And so I went again into the room, and I was bombarding the heavens heavily. I just discovered that before I called Jack, I slept off. And I woke up hours after. And I was angry with myself. Very angry. And I woke up angry, trying to pick myself again. I heard, before you call, I will answer. I said, Satan, get thee behind me. You don't want me to pray. Because I was already used to an antecedent of praying for plenty hours. And then God will answer me. But this time God said, before you call, I have answered. Every attempt to want to pray did not work. And dearly beloved, that same month again, my wife took in for our second child. So, this is how you mount it up, step by step, stage by stage. I remember in those days, in the 70s, we want to make a trip, and there's something that says, no, don't go. Who you are looking for is coming to meet you. And various like that. So, you begin to grow it. You are sensitive to his voice. You see, it's not enough to pray. You must listen. One day I woke up while I was praying for, bombarding the heavens concerning life partner, and I had received a lady of who I was to marry. I heard God say, go and speak to her clearly. I went, and then I was waiting for an answer. Then one day, I heard God. It was just about the time I was going to do my first degree convocation to Alaba Market to purchase some things. And I heard that voice say, get a wristwatch. Today, she's going to say yes to you. And this to show you how you have to learn. At times you miss it, you grow, you repent, and then you make it again. But I did not buy it. I was like, that's presumption. And sincerely, dearly beloved, the same day, that same evening, my wife said yes to me. And then I confessed to her that how wonderful would it have been if I brought out my wristwatch that day and said, darling, this to mark this, the birth of our courtship. And she actually kept asking for a wristwatch for years. Eventually, I think I did. So, from there, I've learned to master his voice. So when is the one speaking? I can do it. And this is how it goes. So, sensitivity. A mindset that wants to do his perfect will. Praise the Lord. Now, I haven't talked about you. We have looked at being acquainted with the Holy Spirit. You get acquainted with the Holy Spirit by praying the Spirit. You get acquainted with the Holy Spirit by listening, by meditation, by opening up, hallelujah, by learning about the Holy Spirit himself, his person, his personality, his acts, his ways. You are getting acquainted. You run through scriptures, the places where the Holy Spirit did one thing or the other, then you get to know his ways. That's very important. The next thing that will enhance your ability to hear is to be flexible. Rigidity is dangerous. Now, in our early faith, we used to have, there are some questions when they ask you, the answer is already ahead. I remember in those days, one of such was, if you are in the bus, you are having your Bible, and somebody says, please borrow me your Bible. Will you borrow him? If you say you will, so the person can read the word of life, they say, that means you are giving away your own sword. You know, without that answer, you must not give it. But when we look at it in retrospect, when you have answers to every question ready made, then you don't need God. You don't need the Holy Spirit. That's why flexibility comes in. Later, we grew to understand that the word of God in your hand is not what is useful. It's the word in your heart. It's the word that is inside that you can apply. The devil is not going to let you look for concordance or start checking a verse of scriptures. So even if somebody takes the Bible, my physical Bible from me, he has not taken the word of life from inside me. So that's talking about rigidity. Some people already have answers to everything. So you must become flexible, pliable in the hands of the Lord, not rigid. Hallelujah. The Bible says the wind bloweth where it listeth. That's what you become. You exactly That's what the Spirit of God is saying about the born again Christian. You are blown here and there under the influence of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You are stable and you are walking with Him. Praise God. You allow Him to do what He wants to do. You are ready for His release. He said, Lord, have your right of way. Where you turn me, I will turn. So, this is very important. Flexibility enhances our walk with God. And the book of Ezekiel chapter 47 is very, very handy on the issue of the walk with God. Ezekiel chapter 47, and I like to read from verse 1, and let's see how it goes. Ezekiel chapter 47, walking with God. From verse 1, it says, afterward, he brought me again unto the door of the house. And behold, waters issued out from under the threshold of the house eastward. For the forefront of the house stood towards the east. And the waters came down from under the right side of the house at the south side of the altar. Then brought he me out of the way of the gate northward, and led me about the way without unto the outer gate by the way that looked eastward. And behold, there ran out waters on the right side. And when the man that had a line in his hand went forth eastward, he measured 1,000 cubits. And he brought me through the waters. The waters were to the ankles. Again, he measured 1,000 and brought me through the waters, and the waters were to the knees. Number 2. Number 3. Again, he measured 1,000 and brought me through the waters, and they were to the loins. Verse 5. Afterward, he measured 1,000 and it was a river, and I could not pass over, for the waters were rising, waters to swim in, a river that could not be passed over. Can somebody shout hallelujah? This passage has a lot to say. And each one of us must understand it. It started from the ankle. The water was flowing. The word of God is the water of life. It's for our cleansing. It's to direct us. It's to lead us. Water, 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 water. By it we are washed. By it we are cleansed. By it we are fed. By it we are directed and guided. And it started from the ankle. I hope you know water at your ankle is easy to walk through. So God is trying to show us what will follow once you want to start to walk with Him. What must be. And this is very important for us, step by step, in walking, in understanding God, in getting to a point where we begin to swim. We are directed by the Spirit. And everything is just walking. Line is falling upon lines. We are having goodly heritage. So it starts with the walk. And, you know, God now took that man another 1,000. And it got to the knees. In your walk with God, God is showing that you must get to a point where you must know how to bow your knees, how to pray, how to seek God. It's a steady progression. And every believer who wants to have higher experiences with God must go through progression. Praise the Lord. So, it started with that, and then it got to the ankle. Then after the ankle, it got to the knees. And that is talking about your ability to pray. Your ability to pray, to intercede. Deep prayer. We are not talking of ordinary praying. We are talking about you being able to get in line with the counsel of God in prayer. Hallelujah. So, you are able to pray. You are able to seek the face of God. This is very vital. Intercession. Strong intercession. And you see, this is very important in hearing God. You are focused. You can bend your knees. And those who bend their knees will never bow before men. Those who bow before God never bow before men. That's talking about travail. 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 And when you run through, you discover that in the plan of God, in our walk with God, we need to get it very clear that to get to the point where we can pray, a lot of things will have taken place in our walk with God. God will deal with something, some cleansing, some purification. Because the only prayer that God hears from the sinner is a prayer of repentance. So God is going to, in your walk, you know, from Hanku to the point where you are bending your knees, there's a cleansing walk that will take place. We read in 1 Thessalonians that chapter 5, our sanctification. We are purified by the blood. We are cleansed. We begin to live a pure life. The Bible says in Psalm 24 verse 3, who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? Because you want a walk with God to a point where you can begin to hear him. He's talking to you. You are talking to him. It means bringing you. He says, come up either. So the ability to walk with God requires a cleansing and a purification. Your life must be put right. And your walk with God must be pure. God will make a demand upon your life. If you want to deal with every corny craftiness, every hypocrisy, because he will not tolerate them. I've come to understand this about God. One major thing with anybody who is going to walk with him, the first key thing often is purity, holy living. In the book of Genesis chapter 17, before 17, Abraham was called in chapter 12. And then he got to 17, the Bible says, and when Abraham was 90 years old and 9, the Lord appeared to Abraham and said unto him, I am the Almighty God, walk before me and be thou perfect. So anyone who is going to consistently hear from God, he's a man who wants to walk in perfection. That's why he says, yeah, he measured and the water reached the ankle. So, God was trying to say to him, no more nonsense. You have to keep yourself pure. You have to walk in holiness. And that's exactly the work. Whosoever wants to hear God, whosoever wants to ascend to his holy hill, this is important. The Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 19. He says, nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are his. And let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Praise the Lord. So, it doesn't matter what others are saying. You know, there are occasions nobody knows your inner life. Nobody knows the secret of your life. And they say, oh, that brother is very, very serious. Oh, that brother is very, very spiritual. Don't let that get to your head. You know yourself. Man looks at the outward, but God looks inward. You want to get to a point where you are hearing it per second, per second. Keep yourself pure. Walk away from hypocrisy. Don't be a slanderer. Don't ruin others. Don't backbite. Walk in the light. Be straight. And that means you are truly preparing yourself to become what God wants you to become. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's possible your leader, your pastor, your spiritual father, whosoever, might be having a good account about you. But what is God's account? Very important. Praise the Lord. How is God going to score you? Don't play games with God. Bible says in 1 Samuel 16 verse 7, man looks at the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart. So God is looking at your inside. Let your inside be clean. Vessel unto honor. Praise the Lord. So you want to experience the power of God, you want to experience the flow of His grace in your life, you want to walk with Him, your primary concern must be purity. Walk in the light. Some people, they've deceived. They say, yes, I got it. You only got it with man, but not with God. Let's keep ourselves pure. You see, this lockdown is amazing. Actually, is calling for sober reflection. Looking what every saint, walk in the light. No game playing. Can you imagine this? It just came on us suddenly. That's how rapture will come. Every plan dislodged. All who had the plan of I'm going to US, some visas, tickets, purchased everything. Everything is just grounded. So we need to understand all our plans must be secured in Him. We must be under His influence. Hallelujah. So look inward, search yourself, assure yourself you are right, take away every hypocrisy so you will not be ashamed. It is better to be ashamed on earth than to be ashamed in heaven. Hallelujah. So in walking with God, you must remember that He knows you. Now, if there's anything I love in my, that I love as a person, is I like to be myself. I like to be frank. I like to be sincere. When I'm weak, I'm not going to feign myself as strong. When I'm down, I don't want to feign myself as up. And let me warn you, you are not dealing with man, you are dealing with God. All this packaging and trying to dramatize, let people feel you are. No, at times we even behave as superhuman. I'm just a man like anybody. Just the grace of God in us that makes all the difference. So, and don't portray to people as if, oh, you can't fail. Oh, you cannot make a mistake. You will always be right. May God help us. In the mighty name of Jesus. So, this is the way by which we will not mark time. The Bible says the righteous man will fall 7 times and he will rise again. When you are down, don't remain at the same spot. But don't feign yourself as all right when you are down. And this is why so many people. Now, let me just say this. When you are down, that's not the time to start to take decisions. You are backsliding. You are down as a lady. You want to be making a choice of a life partner at that time. Your choice will go wrong. But you are backsliding. Be restored. Rise up. Go for help. Confess it. When it seems as if you are cut off, you are not very confident that you are in tune. It's like your connection is cut off. Then return until you find it back. Don't keep on building castles in the air. This is why so many people miss it. Just be yourself. You are low, agree you are low, and then do everything. Where you can't help yourself, look for a friend. Look for a spiritual, somebody higher than you. Look for your pastor. Look for someone. And then, yes, I'm not okay. I want to be okay. And then you can even seek prayer partners. Let's pray together. It's like my prayer life is going down. And then you pick it up. By so doing, your sensitivity will be consistent. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So, our walk with God is very important if we really desire to flow with God in the realm of the Spirit. The next is being prayerful. That's at the level of the knees. The water gets to the knees. This is the symbolic of travail. Before travail, there's a cleansing. God is talking about your walk. He said to Abraham, walk before me and be thou perfect. No more nonsense. No more lying. No more deceit. Walk before me and be ye perfect. Hallelujah. So that's talking about travail. Amen. So it's not enough to cleanse your ways. God wants to bring you to a place of intercession, strong intercession, where you see God in prayers. The Bible says, as soon as Zion travailed, she brought forth a male child. If the Spirit of God will flow through you unhindered, then prayer is very important. Prayer is very important. Prayer brings you to a realm in the Spirit. Hallelujah. You cannot be a weakling in prayer and expect to keep hearing from God. And then there are many things that prayer does in the life of a believer. As you pray, you will discover that your flesh will be subdued. Your spirit will be strengthened. And that is giving ascendancy to your spirit man. So your flesh is not in control of your life. Strong intercessions will touch God. So as you move from one level to another by working with God to the level of deep intercession and travail, your spiritual life is developing. Hallelujah. You must move up from 1 hour a day to 3 hours. You must be able to say 3 hours, now you can pray for 4 hours. You must build your prayer life. Build it. Take statistics of how much, what is the longest time you have prayed in life? Uninterrupted. You have to grow it. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So, as we learn to pray, intercede, we are traveling, testimonies will begin to come. Let me say this, I say it with big mouth all the time. If you claim to be a praying saint, then you must be having testimonies. There must be testimonies to show. Because God does not file prayers. God answers them. Praise God. And in Jesus' name, God will answer your prayers. You learn to pray as we have discussed earlier in Matthew chapter 6. Where Jesus gave us a pattern to pray. A lot begins to happen. Bodies become created. May I say this quickly? Now, they could call you into the intercessory group. It doesn't make you an intercessor. It depends on how you use that position. What you do with it that will determine whether you end up an intercessor. Because to be an intercessor, there are a lot that God will do. A lot of work, a lot of things. Now, when you become an intercessor, you become a go-between. God can now rely on you. God can depend on you. Now, God by the Holy Spirit can bring burden into your heart. A heavy burden. Because he knows that you will push through. When they come, you are not a burden bearer or burden carrier. God expects when the burden comes, you lift it back to him by the help of the Holy Spirit. And then God will begin to count on you. God will begin to send burdens, prayer requests, will begin to send it to you. He knows you will handle it correctly. Because God will do nothing but in answer to the prayer of his saints. And God is always looking for a man. Where there is no man, God cannot help. Hallelujah. The Lord will depend on you in the mighty name of Jesus. You will excel. Then breakthroughs begin to come through you. Before you know it, you get to a point where you are hearing God with precision. Prayer is very, very vital. It's not just any kind of prayer. It's not just voluminous nonsense. But effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous man, which avails much. James 5:16. Then he measured again another 1,000 and brought me the waters was to the loins. At the level of your knees, you discover you can see way through any water. Then when it gets to the loins, your loins is like the central part of you where your center of gravity is. It's 50-50. This is the place of strength and fruitfulness. Hallelujah. That's another progression. It talks about strength, that level, strength and fruitfulness. Your center of gravity is about that point. So you are like, you know, balancing, almost, you know. And then by the law of flotation, the body will displace its own mass in water. So when it gets to your loin, you are walking through the waters, there seems to be a balance somehow. You are being moved, and you are moving, and you are standing. Praise God. So this is very, very important. So before a man can be productive, before a man can have strength, he must be different from the previous ones where you could try to walk. If you try to walk at this level, you will be drowned. So this is a progression in the move of the spirit in our lives. One level of sensitivity and submissiveness. Each step takes something. And that will determine how you will move in life. It's my honest prayer that each one of us will become conversant, begin to walk. There used to be a time, maybe in your life, where if you pray for 30 minutes, you are happy. And there will be a time you have not prayed, you have not even worshipped for 3 hours, you are sorrowful. You are growing, you are moving up. And each of these spiritual exercises, they tune your human spirit. They become sensitive. They can get signals. They can receive. They can hear. And then it will be easy for you to know exactly that this is God. And then you're able to take appropriate steps. Sensitivity of your spirit. Developing a sensitive spirit. You are walking, you are under divine influence. Hallelujah. You are listening. You are somewhere. You are not just cha 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 cha. Now, if you are going to succeed in this area, it's important to minimize your chatting. Everywhere you get to, some people like to be noticed. The still small voice, God does not make noise. So you have to calm yourself. You just relax. I even say this to you. If you are mixed people and they are discussing, they want people to contribute to something, don't be the first to talk. Calm down. Relax. Listen to others. And open up to the Holy Spirit. This is very, very important. In fact, if you are going to get answers to questions, if you are going to flow in wisdom, this is very, very vital. Says if you calm down, you relax. Now, if you spend morning till night, 24/7, everything all over the places, you will miss out. It will be difficult for your spirit man to become. It means he's not even inclining to the Holy Spirit for signal from above. So we have to calm down. Praise the Lord. So that God can become glorified in our lives. Praise the Lord. I look back and let me just say to you this way. You are leading prayers. Even when you are leading prayers, even when you are preaching, you are switching on. You have become so acquainted to listening for the voice of the Spirit. You have so trained your human spirit to be sensitive. I've had occasions I'm leading prayer. Now, let me say this. I want to just say this. Part of our spiritual sensitivity and spiritual growth. It's not every time you are praying that you have to look at the books. It's not every time it has to be what you have written down. If you want to learn to be acquainted with the Spirit of God, you want your spirit man to be sensitive, then just learn the art of being quiet. Many times, I'm up there leading people in prayer. Most times, I love to lead prayers. Well, I might have some things in mind, some things might have been written, but I like to open up. And I've seen God spoke to me various times from this kind. I mean, in that kind of, I remember, I have my request. And one day, he just said to me, when are you going to ask me to bless you? I had. Because I maintain sensitivity to the Holy Spirit whenever I'm doing anything, even when I'm preaching. By so doing, your life will become fruitful. You begin to get sickness. You can go into tête-à-tête with God. And you discover that that will be a great deliverance for your life, for your destiny, for your calling, for your ministry, for your family, for all your endeavors. And God will become exalted. If you will not outstay a phase of your life, your sensitivity to the Holy Spirit is very, very important. And I prophesy in the name of Jesus, you will do well. You will do well. I could not go beyond developing a sensitive spirit. By the grace of God, we'll look at that, the other one, that's sensitivity to the Holy Spirit. Becoming sensitive to the Holy Spirit. And Jehovah will help us in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let's just spend some time to pray. I hope you are following. I hope you are looking back to what we have said before. Putting it together, building yourself so you can grow to hearing God. Praise the Lord. However, it's important if you are not born again, you must first be born again so you can have access to divine connection. You can't connect to Him without being His own. So salvation is first. If you are backsliding, seek restoration. Be restored. And then your spirit will link with the Spirit of God. Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Wherever you are, if you are not saved, you can just ask Jesus to come in. Lord Jesus, I open my heart to you. Come in. Be my Lord and my Savior. Make me your child. Write my name in the book of life. And I will serve you forever. Thank Him for saving you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Heavenly Father, I ask you to honor this request from everyone that is making it. You who is able to do exceeding abundantly above what we ask or think, please help them and secure their salvation and keep them in the path of life. Link them up for growth in a living assembly. Thank you, righteous Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father in heaven, I pray for everyone who has heard this word. I speak life to you. I command everything that has blocked your hearing aid to be removed. That area where you need God, tonight the Lord will give you a visitation. The power of the Holy Spirit will break through for you. That question that has not been answered, tonight the Lord will answer them. In the name of Jesus, receive clarity. Receive clarity. I come against every confusion. Every plan of the wicked to make you to run from pillar to post, I banish. In the name of Jesus, every untoward plan of the wicked in your life, I command them to be shattered in the name of Jesus. I speak peace to your matrimony. I speak peace to your matrimony. And I speak by faith, I deliver you from wrong steps. I deliver you from wrong actions in the name of Jesus. I deliver you from yourself. I deliver you from every contrary voice. I deliver you from every plan of the wicked. The counsel of God will stand in your life. From today, it becomes easy for you to be directed, easy to be inspired, easy to be helped up in the name of Jesus. And I speak by faith, whatsoever is troubling you, ask that the power of the Most High God will give you an answer. We'll show you the source and we'll dry it up in the name of Jesus. Go and prosper. Go and excel. Go and reach your optimum. Whatsoever has been lost, become restored. Whatsoever is dying, ceases to die. I speak life to them in the name of Jesus. By the anointing, your way shall be straight. By the anointing, your way shall be straight. Your valley shall be filled. In the mighty name of Jesus, your mountain shall be brought down. I release the anointing and I command every yoke destroyed in your body, every sickness eaten up in the name of Jesus, receive life. And I say peace to every matrimony that is in turmoil. I say peace be still. I calm every storm. Receive the peace of God. Thank you, Jehovah. Let there be restoration between husband and wife, between children and parents. And let them walk in the counsel of God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I pronounce you blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed perpetually. So let it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. And the people of God say, praise the Lord. Beautiful time. You can't be the same again. Just go on through the spiritual exercises and you will discover you will never be the same again. You will not be low. Your prayer life is gaining ascendancy. You pray more than ever before. You become sensitive and you will hear the voice of God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Praise God. So, wonderful. I just want us to bring out our offering very quickly. You can just raise it and I pray for you. Father in heaven, I pray for everyone bringing his or her offering or bringing a tithe. I ask your blessing will abound upon them. I ask that the heavens over there will open in the mighty name of Jesus. We plead with you, Jehovah the Most High, that they will never know a better last year. Thank you, thank you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. You can make a transfer and then if you give it, you can just make sure it gets to them in the office. You are blessed. I hope you are doing well. The Lord will continue to carry you. I want to believe the Lord that the time we have spent in lockdown cannot be compared with what is yet to be spent. In the mighty name of Jesus, it shall be very quick. This lockdown shall be terminated. We shall have our life back in Jesus' name. And by the time it's over, we will lose nothing to the adversary in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Thursday, we shall be having the Zoom. Don't forget, join us again. The Lord bless you. Can we make our confessions? 1, 2, now unto the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. And the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work and preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Praise the Lord. Before we say our God reigns, please try and link up with people, friends, members of your unit, people in your cell, house fellowship, etc., and say hi to them. Be sure everybody is fine. The good Lord keep and bless you. 1, 2, go. Our God reigns. Our God reigns. Our God reigns. He reigns forever in your life. Praise God. People in your cell, house fellowship.